Hey there, everybody. Today I'd like to chat about the upcoming E3 2021 Gaming Trade Show. Now, I won't be discussing every conference, mainly due to a lack of time and specific interest. However, I'll try to at least cover the main ones I'm looking forward to, some of the games I think we're likely to see, and a few I think would make for a pretty fun surprise. So let's just dive into it, shall we? Now first, on Saturday, June 12th, we got Ubisoft's presentation at 12 p.m. with a pre-show at 11 a.m. Now, what we can expect from them is probably more to do with Assassin's Creed Valhalla, maybe some more DLC for that. I think it's a bit too early to see any new Assassin's Creed games coming out, but beyond that, I think we may possibly see more Beyond Good and Evil 2. They kind of teased that at a previous E3, and we haven't really heard anything about it since, so that would at least be nice to see. Ubisoft also owns the Tom Clancy license, including Rainbow Six, which the current game Siege is still going pretty strong about 4 or 5 years in now. They're adding new operators all the time, so that's a good time. I think it's unlikely we'll see a new addition to that series. Maybe just a new operator or two, who knows. But apart from that, they also own Splinter Cell, which I believe that series came to an end, but you never know. Studios are always rebooting franchises these days. We might see something with that. Additionally, we got Far Cry 6 coming out late this year. I don't really know too much about it. I never really got into the Far Cry series, though I know they're really popular. But I will say the trailer looked pretty awesome, so I'm curious to see more about that if they show more. And really, finally from Ubisoft, there have been rumors floating around the interwebs that they got their hands on the Star Wars license, at least enough to make a game. So I'm really curious if we'll see anything from them in that regard. I was hoping back around May 4th, Star Wars Day, that we'd see some actual game announcements, but we really didn't for the most part, so that was somewhat surprising. So hopefully they'll showcase something there. Now that's about all I'm covering on the 12th, though there are a few, I think, more minor developers that day. So anyway, on to Sunday, June 13th, we have the Xbox and Bethesda presentation at 10 a.m., which I am super excited for. I really want to see more Halo Infinite. What they've shown so far seems interesting. I mean, it seems pretty derivative gameplay-wise of Doom Eternal, with a few re-added in additions from earlier Halo games, which seems kind of cool. I don't know if I really care for the art style, like the blocky cliffs and aesthetic of it, but graphically it looks alright. Xbox also has Gears of War, which I don't even know what game that series is on, having not really followed it myself, but it's possible we'll see some more Gears of War stuff. I don't know if there's been a proper Gears of War game for next gen yet, but to be honest, the Xbox Series X seems to be kind of lagging right now in terms of actual proper first-party support. The only notable titles Xbox really even has is Halo, Gears of War, and Forza. I don't really care about Forza, so I don't have anything to say about that, but who knows, maybe we'll at least see something new from Gears of War. Now on the Bethesda side, I think it'd be pretty funny to see like a Skyrim remastered for new consoles. You know, getting those really pretty HHDDD graphics, you know, 4K textures and all that fancy stuff, complete new relighting. I don't know, I just think that could be amusing if they announced that rather than actually talking about Elder Scrolls 6, which I think is what a lot of people are really excited to hear about right now. Though from the few articles I've read, it seems like that might not even be coming till like 2022 or 23, but the sooner upcoming game is supposed to be Starfield. Now I'm really curious to see what Bethesda does with that. It seems like it might be some kind of space RPG. We've really seen next to nothing about that so far, so I would love to see some new details on Starfield from Bethesda. Apart from that, I would like to see more on Deathloop from Arkane Studios. Arkane Studios has made some great games. They made that PrE3 reboot in 2016, I believe, maybe 2017. And they also made the two Dishonored games, which are pretty dope. So I think that Deathloop game looked pretty interesting, and the way it integrates co-op with sort of respawning and coming back to life. I don't know, it just seems like a really interesting concept, so I would love to see more about that and maybe see some actual gameplay, because what we've seen in the past doesn't seem as much like gameplay as it just seems like in-engine graphics-y, cutscenes-y stuff. I don't know. As was teased earlier this year, Fable 4 should be coming to Xbox, so that's pretty exciting. I haven't dipped as many toes into the Fable series as I would like, because they look like really fun games, but it just seems like a big time commitment to really, really dig into them. But I'd love to see more about Fable 4. And finally, I know that Microsoft also owns Rare, so it would be really cool maybe to see, I know this is a long shot, but maybe a new Banjo-Kazooie or even just a remaster of the originals. I know the Banjo-Kazooie games, I believe, are on Xbox Game Pass, but I don't know, something new from that franchise would be pretty cool, other than, like, I don't know, the third one was kind of like a racing game, which was weird. I don't know, I just feel like a classic 3D platformer would be fun, especially since a lot of what we've gotten recently from 3D platformers, apart from your staple Mario games, was like... Yeah, no, nothing's coming to mind. Can't think of anything. We haven't had a proper 3D platformer with that classic feel in a while, so I think that'd be really cool. Now, after their show, Xbox and Bethesda's, we got Square Enix with a presentation at 12:15 p.m. I don't know why they picked 12:15. Seems like an arbitrary time to me, but I look forward to covering that. We might see more Life is Strange stuff. I don't know. I played Life is Strange. I streamed it. You can check that out on the channel, but I didn't really care for it, to be honest, personally. A lot of people really seem to love that game, though, and its sequel and prequel and spinoff? I don't know, man. They got some weird stuff for that. Hopefully, we'll also see more either about Final Fantasy 16. I'd love to see some stuff on that. Or Final Fantasy 7 Part 2 would be really cool. Along with more Final Fantasy stuff, I would love to see more about the upcoming James Bond game from IO Interactive. They're a subsidiary of Square Enix that has most famously worked on the Hitman reboot trilogy, and those games are super awesome. And I really want to see how they integrate that sort of small, open-ish world design and intricate gameplay options. I'd love to see how they integrate all of those aspects into the James Bond IP. I'm also curious which Bond they're gonna go for. Part of me thinks they're probably gonna go with Craig, but you never know. Maybe they'll have a few throwbacks to older ones. But I just generally think that'll be fun, and it might have a decent or enjoyable multiplayer too. Maybe kind of a throwback to old GoldenEye or Nightfire. Now on Monday, June 14th, we're kicking it off with the Capcom show at 2:30 p.m. And there's plenty of other minor shows across these days, but like I said, I'm just focusing on the main ones I'm interested in, because if I was going to cover them all, this video would be way too long. So anyway, we got Capcom at 2:30 p.m. I know they're working right now on their Great Ace Attorney collection. It's a continuation of the Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney series. So I'm interested to see where that project goes and if we'll see anything about that. Apart from that, of course, Capcom is well known for Resident Evil, but Resident Evil just had a game with Resident Evil 8, so I don't really know what they're gonna do in that regard. Is it gonna get some DLC? Who knows? However, there is also apparently a Netflix show coming out for Resident Evil, a live-action one and also an animated one, both of which I'd be interested to see something about, and you might hear me talking more about those in a later video once they eventually come out, if they come out. Apart from Resident Evil, maybe we'll see something about Street Fighter, be it Street Fighter 6, or a remaster of an older Street Fighter game, or maybe they'll bring some games to Nintendo's eShop. I don't know. You never know. Capcom, it's honestly bizarre that they're even at this E3. I don't feel like I've seen them at any previous E3s, so it's going to be really interesting to see what they can bring to the table. Also, we might see something more with Mega Man. The last Mega Man game we got was Mega Man 11, was it like a couple years ago? And from what I've heard, that was a really good Mega Man game, so maybe we'll see Mega Man 12. Now, of course, probably one of the biggest studios showing off at E3 is Nintendo. Now, Nintendo's show is going to be on June 15th at 9 a.m., way too early, but I'm really hoping to hear about a new Switch model so I can finally buy a Switch in good conscience. I just want them to fix the Joy-Con stuff, man. The fact that those controllers have a really short lifespan is, oh, it's the biggest bummer to me, honestly. But apart from that, of course, we'll hopefully hear more about Metroid Prime 4. That would be super exciting, as well as Breath of the Wild 2. I mean, it is Zelda's 35th anniversary, so I feel like that really opens a lot of doors in terms of what they could showcase for Zelda. Much as last year, they did a Mario 3D Collection All-Stars thing with Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, and Super Mario Galaxy. I think it'd be cool to see maybe a Zelda 2D Collection with the original Legend of Zelda, Zelda 2, and A Link to the Past. Maybe all somewhat remastered or at least brought up to date to current graphical standards. I think that would be enjoyable, especially Zelda 2, because I always felt like that was kind of the black sheep of the series, and one not many people nowadays would have gotten to experience, because it wasn't as popular. It tried a lot of weird things, and some paid off and some didn't. Maybe we'll even see, like, a Zelda 35. I think that would be hilarious. Like, I'm just imagining 35 little Links running around Hyrule, like, completing dungeons and, dropping monsters onto each other. I have no idea. I'm just purely throwing that out there for shits and giggles. Apart from that, of course, they have Bayonetta. Maybe we'll see something with Bayonetta 3. And also, I would love to see a new Mario Kart, because while Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is great, it came out, like, 4 years ago, and it's just starting to become a bit stale. So I would love to see a new Mario Kart entry in the series. Maybe something along the lines of Smash Ultimate, where they're bringing back all the maps and characters from previous games. That would be awesome. I would even love to see them introduce maybe like a Double Dash mode, kind of recreating that feeling of playing Double Dash in the GameCube, because obviously that game is really expensive right now, so not everybody, like me, gonna play it. And I think playing something like that, kind of updated to modern controls, could be really fun. Also, hopefully we'll see more about Splatoon 3. So yeah, Nintendo's gonna have a jam-packed 40-minute presentation. Apparently it's only 40 minutes. I don't know how they'll do it, but we'll see. Hopefully it won't just be like 50 indie titles no one's ever heard of, but you never know. Then at 2:25 p.m., another weird time, guys. Come on, E3 fellas. What are you doing? What are you doing? Just have like normal human times, please. But at 2:25 p.m., Bandai Namco is supposed to have a presentation. I can't even tell you what I'm expecting from them. The only thing I can really think we'll hear about, and they'll probably dip heavily on, is Elden Ring, the new game from From Software, the creators of the Dark Souls games, Bloodborne, and Sekiro. I am super excited to hear about that. I would love to see maybe some gameplay, a proper trailer. I don't know. I'm in the dark on a lot of these things. I'm really just excited going into this blind. Okay, now that's everything for the official E3 lineup. Supposedly, we're gonna see something from Intellivision there, which, if you don't know, Intellivision's like a really, really old game studio that apparently was recently bought by some guy. So, I don't know. I don't even know what we're gonna see from them. That's a weird one. That's a head-scratcher right there. I think it'd be fun, though, if maybe we saw, like, a retro console from Intellivision. That would be cool. I don't know. Just something to be able to actually play those old games, because I feel like these days, really, really old games like that are almost impossible to, like, come by in decent condition, and then you gotta get the system and be able to set it up with modern hardware. So yeah, I have no idea what to expect from Intellivision, but that might be, I don't know, there might be like a fun little treat in E3 this year. We'll just have to see together. Additionally, Konami was supposed to have a panel, which, I don't know, I was actually really excited when I heard Konami was going to be at E3, because I know there was that canceled Silent Hills game, so I was interested to hear more potentially about that, maybe if they like rebooted it or restarted it. Obviously, they wouldn't have Kojima involved, because there was a pretty bad falling out between him and the studio, but I don't know, just Silent Hill at this point feels kind of like a dead franchise, and I really appreciate what those early games did for horror. They have really interesting kind of psychological horror that wasn't really tackled too well in a lot of games at the time. Apart from that, Konami, they got Metal Gear Solid, which the last thing we saw from that was Metal Gear Survive, which was abysmal. And Metal Gear Solid 5, which I don't even think, like, the story was never properly finished. I don't know, man. That shit's weird. Like, other than that, I just don't know what to expect from Konami. And the reason they canceled, too, is apparently they're working on some game projects right now. So they are doing something. Like, I thought they'd just been making pachinko machines in Japan for the last 5 years, but I guess not. The only other thing that they own that's a big IP is Castlevania. I mean, the anime for Castlevania on Netflix is fucking awesome. It just finished its 4th season, and it was great. I would really recommend that. It's very mature, though, so, you know, just approach it with that mindset. But I think it's a good watch. I've always thought a 3D Castlevania would be pretty cool. I'm not really going to talk too long. In fact, I'm not going to talk about that at all right now, because I plan to make a video about that, what I think would make for an interesting Castlevania game. Now, the only other final actual presentation, which isn't connected to E3, is EA Play, but that's not until July 22nd. Yeah, that's right. Like, over a month after actual E3, EA is having their own little presentation. I don't know what the hell that's about. It doesn't make any sense. Like, what are we gonna see? Sims 5? Sports stuff? Battlefield 6? Like, are they done with Star Wars? Are they still making Star Wars games? I don't even know. Like, EA usually has some good indie games, but apart from that, I just don't understand, I guess, what their main draw is, what their main attention grab is for their own presentation. Like, I'll give it a watch, mostly out of morbid curiosity, but honestly, I just don't know what they have to offer these days. Because the thing was before, EA was at least clumped in with E3, so you'd kind of watch it as part of the experience. But now that it's its own thing, it just, I don't know, I just don't get it. Also, Sony apparently already had their State of Play presentation on April 29th, which I apparently streamed but have no memory of. And they apparently had another one on May 27th, which I heard nothing about. And it was seemingly just basically a reveal of some Horizon Forbidden West gameplay, which is cool. But that's also what I thought the Guerrilla Games E3 show was supposed to be about. So, color me a bit confused. Yeah, I don't really know what PlayStation's doing, but I can tell you for certain what it's not doing. Which is producing enough PlayStation 5s. Anyhow, apologies for how close to E3 this video is coming out, but considering the fact that some of the game studios involved just finally released their conferences dates and times about a day ago from when I'm recording this, it would have been basically impossible to release it any earlier while still covering as many studios of interest as I could. Now, if you enjoyed the video, I'll be streaming those E3 conferences I just discussed live here on my YouTube channel and on my Twitch channel. So feel free to drop by and join me, and see what's next for video games. Anyhow, take care of yourselves and each other. Much love and respect, James C. Drone. Signing off.